I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're talking about full facial treatments. I'm always asked about it. There's trainings all around the country. We're going to address it today. So around the country, and what we're always asked about is how to address the whole face and what tools do you need. And today I'm going to go through the top three reasons why injectors around the country are not injecting the whole face or considering the whole face in their treatment plan. And then what I think are the top five tools needed in a practice to do this. The full face treatment, to me, not many people walk in the door looking for a consult that want a portion of the face treated. They don't want a fold or a line. They want to overall look better. They might want a new angle. They might want slightly larger lips. But the whole three-dimensional face is what's most important, and it's what we should be doing now in this country, and it's what we have the tools for. So what are the three reasons why we aren't doing this? Number one is the consult. So the consult is key in determining what can be done. Are we dealing with a full face that needs some angles? Are we dealing with a face that we need to remove a little bit of fat, create illusions that there isn't a heaviness in certain areas? Do we need collagen stimulation? What is it that's being done? And then guesstimating the cost and what it's going to take to do this. And that is one of the reasons, is number two, is the money. It's much more expensive to address the full face, and how do we get around it? Because it's hard to tell people the end result, but we need to, and that is by making a treatment plan that incorporates the whole treatment and allowing people to have that plan to incorporate over the next year to two with long-lasting products to get where they want. The third reason is that people just aren't taught how to do it. And this is really common because we depend still, like we did 15 and 20 years ago in this country, on learning through the companies. Understanding the companies cannot teach these combinations because they're not all FDA approved in combination, and some of the areas are what we call off-label. Very common to treat, but it's hard to get the teaching. So different conferences and CME events and private trainers are your best bet. And that's just very popular, and it's the way it is now in America. This is a paradigm shift for us. So the top five tools, we're gonna start with number one, which is the most common injectable treatment, is neuromodulators. While we have to support the areas with filler and collagen stimulators, because we're getting sag and we're getting hyperdynamic muscle movement because of the loss of support in the face, and this is somewhat of a new concept, you still need neuromodulators to stop and slow down muscle movement appropriate in certain areas. A classic example is the lower face, and again, an off-label treatment. Support with fillers, but there still needs to be a component of low-dose neuromodulators. Number two, and the most common filler type, hyaluronic acid fillers. Most people are well versed with these. I will add a caveat that using a microcannula, which we can now teach in this country with Restylane Silk, it is FDA approved, is going to help. As you see from this picture, all the vessels in the face and the nerves, we need to be very cognizant that some of the areas we're injecting are not as safe as other areas. So using a microcannula for comfort, decreased bruising, and so on is important with these HA fillers. Number three is collagen stimulators, injectable collagen stimulators. This is probably the one area that a lot of people don't use, they don't use enough of, is products that we inject, uses the body's own collagen sources to build its collagen support, and you do get a degree of tightening. And if you follow our channel, you know the collagen stimulators that we use. Number four is PDO threads. So using the threads appropriately, 10 smooth threads to every cog threads is about my ratio, is going to help create lift, help texture tone work with the fillers and the collagen stimulators. A lot of people say, well, can you combine HA fillers with PLLA. Remember that in some places, PLLA was embedded in hyaluronic acid, and hyaluronic acid was thought about to be a carrier for Sculptra. So yes, you can combine those and thread safely once you're taught how to do it. Number five is fat dissolvers. Okay, so Kybella is the FDA approved one in this country, and we don't think of the face anymore without thinking of the jawline and neck. It's very important. Kybella is not the most predictable product we use, such as neuromodulators like Botox and Dysport. So a lot of people don't use it, or they're afraid to use it because of predictability. But if used appropriately and the expectations set, I use a lot of it in my practice because the jawline is very important. Off-label uses you'll see more and more to help slim the jaw for the downturn mouth, for the oral commissure, and those products can be used. There's a way to do it. You have to really select the patients and be well-versed in using it. But reducing fat is very important to creating a V-shape, creating youth, beauty, and addressing the whole face. So addressing the whole face is very important. It's an up-and-coming treatment. We now have the tools. I'm very excited about it. Love to hear your comments below. Join me on Instagram, Facebook, and this YouTube channel for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.